So in this video, let's see at the rate query annotation to modify the records in a database table. So before that, let's go to our DB and check the records. So here I've created a update query. So where I'm updating employees for employee ID 13 and 14. So which is Smith and Bob. I want to activate them. So I just want to reset this active state from false to true. So this is the update query, and this is how we write it in SQL. So let's see how we can achieve this in our repository using @query annotation. So very first thing, let's create our update query here. So we'll be using @query annotation and the update query. Update employee. Employee is my entity class, alias name, and I want to set active to false. So what active state I want to update, I will be receiving it from the endpoint as well as the employee IDs. So in previous video, we have seen achieving this using name parameters, right? So this time let's do it with the help of index parameters. So for that, what you have to do, you have to use question mark and the index of the parameter which will be passing to our method. So I'll say it one, where e dot my employee ID in. So from the endpoint I can pass multiple employees IDs to update multiple records at a time. So for that I'm using in, and then again index parameter 2. So let's write method. Before that, as we know that this is a update query, right? So we have to use one annotation called modifying. So basically this indicates the query is not a select query. So this is not a select query, this is a update query. So we are just indicating by using this @modifying annotation. Now let's write a method. So whenever we are writing any SQL which is modifying our data, in that case this modifying queries can only use void or int or integer wrapper class as a return type, right? So here we are updating employees, right? So whatever method that we write here will return integer value. So this integer value will be the number of records that got updated or inserted or got manipulated. So let's write that method. So I'm calling it update employee state by employee ID. So where this active is boolean, and I'm using in, I'm expecting a list of long because my employee ID type is long. So with this, our method is ready. So to access it, let's create a put endpoint. So I'm calling it update employee state. I'm passing the active state to which we want to update, what active state we want to update, followed by list of employee IDs. So from my endpoint, I will be passing it as a comma separated values for now, and we are receiving these two with the help of this path variable, right? So let's go to our service class. Here let's use our repository method that we have created to modify the record. So employee repository and update employee state by employee ID. So here I will pass the active state and employee ID list. Let's try to restart our application and test our endpoint using Postman. So now my application is started. Let's go to the Postman. So this is my endpoint, update employee state. So where I want to update the state of my employees to true, to active, where employee ID is 13 and 14. So before that, let's go to our database. Now here you can see for employee ID 13 and 14, state is false. So let's run this endpoint. So here you can see it returns 2. That means total number of records that got updated are 2. So let's go to our database and rerun our select. So here you can see 13 and 14 both got updated with this update query. So let's try to make it false, but this time let's do it for 11, 12 and 13. So let me add 11 and 12. So I just want to deactivate all the employees with ID 11, 12 and 13. So let's run it. Now this time you can see total record, total number of records that got updated is 3. So let's go to our database, recheck, and here you can see 3 records got disabled. So in one of our previous video, we have created an endpoint to select all the employees where active is, so where we are receiving active state from the endpoint and designation list from the endpoint also, and in that we have used name parameters, right? If we want to sort the list of employees based on some criteria, so that can be done here. So what we have to do is just we have to pass the sort criteria. So on which basis we want to sort our record. So let's run this one. So I will go to my employee class. So here I will be passing on which property I want to sort the records. So let's say I want to sort by name. So let me import sort. I want to find all the employees by designation and active state data, but I want to sort them on the basis of name. So let's restart our application and try to run this. So my application is up now. Let's go to the Postman. So this is the endpoint, right? Find employee by designation and active state or data. So for all the managers and developers who are in active state, I want to fetch that record, right? So let's try to run this. So now here you can see total 3 records got fetched. So first is Adam, Bob, and Joffrey. So basically it is fetching the records with the help of @query annotation, and as well as it is shorting that record based on this name. If you want to short them by age, we can do that as well. So let's just modify our this, and instead of a name, let's age. Restart our application. Application is up now, and let's try to hit this endpoint again. Now this time the record got shorted based on the age. So 28, 29, and then the 32. This video we have seen how to use @query to modify our records and why we need this @ modifying annotation. And also we have seen like whenever we are using @ modifying annotation for any update, delete, or insert SQLs. So for that, the return type of our method should be int or void. So if we keep it int, it will return the number of records which got updated, deleted, or inserted as per our request. Also, we have seen like when we are fetching our data from @query annotation, we can sort that data based on the criteria as well. So for that, what we have to do is we have to just pass another argument of short class. And in our implementation, we have to pass like on the basis of what we want to short our record. So that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks.